Let's first recap at a high level what event-driven architecture, or EDA, is, and then do a quick comparison with request-response alternatives. Both event-driven and request-response are integration models for distributed software architecture. In request and response, which is often implemented as REST APIs today, there is a client and there's a server. The client initiates a request via an API call and expects the server to respond with the correct data within a certain time limit. In this method, there is both a stamp and temporal coupling. On the other hand, in event-driven architecture, services communicate by producing and consuming events in an intermediate queue, instead of calling each other directly. The service that creates the events and puts into the queue is known as the producer, while the downstream service that monitors the queue and carries out logical processing is known as the consumer. This decouples systems as threads are no longer waiting on the responses and lets them scale independently. This is a commonly encouraged method for distributed architecture in the realm of microservices. But it certainly comes with its own set of challenges and drawbacks.